JAKKS Pacific. Plug and play TV games presenting Pirates of the Caribbean Islands of Fortune. Plug directly into your TV. Featuring four video games built inside. I know, featuring these amazing video games. World map, sword fighting, cannon battle, and treasure hunt. Exciting. It is E for everyone. Yes, I found this in a charity shop for a few quid. Cannot go wrong. Unopened and everything. Pretty darn cool. So today we're going to be opening it and reviewing it. See whether it's absolute garbage or not. I assume it is. But sometimes these games can be pretty fun. And as a fan of Pirates of the Caribbean, I pretty much have to check this out. So yeah, it shows little screenshots of the games in the back. The sword fighting one actually looks pretty darn fun. Reminds me a little bit of Tekken by the looks of it. The world map one also looks interesting, although I don't expect it to be very good. Apparently you're just viewing the map and firing in cannons, but I hope there's more to it than just that. Cannon battle as well. I have no idea. That just looks like a little turret defense type thing. And treasure hunt. That also looks fun. So let's check these out. Here's some warnings, if you care. It requires four AA batteries, not included. It was released in 2007, apparently, by JAKKS Pacific. Oh, thank you so much. So yeah, this is 11 years old. Let's check it out, why not? Someone's obviously got to care about this. I mean, it's Pirates of the Caribbean, everyone loves that, right? Right, so let's open it up. I think they thought this was supposed to be very collectible. This is the first edition, apparently. What a load of garbage. But isn't that one of the coolest things you've ever seen? Holy snap. This is the plug and play. Very cool. As you suspected, it is composite input. Of course it is. It's JAKKS Pacific. But yeah, this is pretty darn cool. Unfortunately, it doesn't actually seal itself down. But that's pretty darn cool. The joystick itself is absolutely hilarious. That is amazing. It's almost like it wasn't meant to be played with. And here's the buttons, of course. You got A and B button. And of course, the menu button. Menu button at the bottom with a nice lovely LED. I bet this looks pretty cool when lit up. That's pretty cool, actually. I do like that. So you can have this little light feature at the front. Either way, pretty darn cool. Do like it. So let's actually look at the damn games. JAKKS Pacific presenting by HotGen. Whoever HotGen are. A subsidiary? I don't know. By Disney! Yay, excitement. Oh boy, you can just hear that amazing music, right guys? Right guys? Just listen to that amazing music. Oh wait. Oh wait. There isn't any other music. That's pretty darn cool. Okay, so let's see. Islands of Fortune. Interesting. How do we change games? I do not know. Let's see, let's start a new game. Starting a new game will overwrite your existing game. Holy snap, I booted this for a second just to see if it worked, and apparently there's save states in this. What? What? This is the first time I've seen a JAKKS Pacific game with any form of saving. That's incredible. I wonder if it stays when you disable actual power by pulling out the batteries. No idea. That is interesting. Welcome to the Caribbean. You're going to have... you have to work hard if you want to become a pirate king. I expect you'll want to know how to sail your ship. Well, listen up. Joystick, steer ship, A, fire, B, map, or island info. You what? Okay, A to continue. Collect as many points as you can to increase your notoriety, allowing you to dock on nearby islands. What are you waiting for? Get out of there and explore the high seas. What? What is this? Okay, so now there's actual volume, which is pretty darn cool. And the compass seems to be pointing us somewhere. Wow, this is pretty darn cool. So, fire the cannons. We only fire one way. Apparently so. We only fire through our right side. Nope. Now we're firing through the other side. I don't know. We could view the map. Okay, nope, this is map information. Your ship. Sword fighting game complete. Hunt game complete. Cannon game complete. Locked island. Island number. Neat. What? What is this? Oh, wow, this game is a lot more in-depth than I expected it to be. I expected it to be four mini-games. But unfortunately not. What's this? Dock ship. Let's see. Island 1. Okay. Oh, is this the four mini-games by any chance?
Oh, we just have to complete it on each one, I suppose. Teach your foe a lesson in the art of swordplay. A to attack, hold A, strong attack, hold A and up, down, adjust height of strong attack, B to block, B up and down to adjust, oh my god, this sounds, what the what, to avoid becoming tired, too many weak attacks can wear you out. What? Vanguard! Alright then, let's do this. It's the only way. I am Captain Jack Tendies. Kamehame, in your face! Kamehame, in your face! Kamehame! Ow. Kamehame, in your face! Wait, can I just swing from all the way out here? Yeah, that'll do. Come here. Yeah. Apparently there's tired out things. I have no idea. I shall block. What are you going to do? Aha! Oh, he's tired! Wrecked! Come on, do it again. Oh, on guard. Let's do this. On guard. On guard. Aha, in your face. Aha, attack me again. I dare you. You won't be able to succeed. You won't. Aha, you never saw it coming. Wait, what's this? Never, never. Aha, I guessed then. Kamehame. Aha, oh, Kamehame. Aha, Kamehame. Aha. Victory is mine, and now he's begging for his life. But it's E for everyone. No one dies in this game. I assume. Such is life. What on earth? Oh, so the tick means it's complete. Oh, so we go to each different island and we have these different challenges. This game is a lot more in-depth than I... Literally, Jack Pacific, you blow me away on this one. Reach the door at the end of the level and try to collect as many points as possible without being caught in any traps. Joystick to move, A to dash, B to jump. What? Okay. Dash, jump. Okay. Aha. Aha. Ooh, what's that? I want it. So this is like a tutorial level type thing. Alright, so we can't do anything with that. Alrighty. This is an interesting game. Find the treasure chest at the end of the level and try to collect as many points as possible without being caught in any traps. Yes, we already know that. Alright, let's do it. Dun, 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 dun. No traps. I don't know. Is there any traps? Can I jump into the water? No, I don't think I can. There we go. Oh, treasure! Aha! Treasure is mine. That was awesome. This... I'm finding this exceptionally fun. Holy snap. What? And I never heard of this until I saw it in the charity shop. Survive the onslaught. I guess this is the cannon one. Left and right to aim cannon. Up and down to aim cannon. Just say use the joystick to aim. A to fire. B's not used. In your face! Oh, nice. You want some too? I am the undefeatable... Oh, there is... This cannon drop. Get it? Cannon drop. At least I think there's cannon drop. I think there's cannon drop. What? Yeah, I think... there's cannon drop. This game is so in-depth that it's got cannon drop. What? What? Although I think it only reaches where you aim. So if I just wait for him and then fire. Nice. That's pretty darn cool, actually. So there's some kind of like weird little cannon drop type thing. So that went a little bit too far. Alrighty. This is actually a fun little mini game. Boom. Look at us. One cannon against a fleet. You never stood a chance. You don't know who you're dealing with? You've conquered your first island. Now add a map marker to another available island and set sail. What? Right, how do you... Right, B to view the map. So, let's see. Place a map marker. So there's... Oh, there's loads of different maps. And that's... I guess that's one we've conquered as well, I guess? From whoever owned this before me. Wait, no one owned this before me! This is brand new! Alright, so I guess this is numbered... They're numbered! I see. Right, okay. There's me going, someone else must have done it. No, that's physically impossible. Right, okay, so the X's means I've not done it yet, I guess. And that means it's been conquered, so we've not actually been to this one. But we've unlocked them, but we can't go to one we haven't unlocked yet, I assume. Okay! That's pretty cool. Wait, can I... So the fun fact is, I can actually fire while in this mode. Huh. Alright, let's go conquer another island. Screw it. I got all day. Why not? Dock the ship. Let's go fight someone's man. This is the guy who's guarding this. You guarding this, bro? I'm the commander-in-chief of the Kamehameha Mans. Come on, come at me. Oh, he knows how to dodge. Yeah, well, not today! Wait, what? Mine comes first. So, what's the stamina of this game? I got you, bro. See that? See how he just backed out? Wow, you got clever AI, bro. It's clever. And whoever's got the lowest health loses, I assume. Oh! Mine came first! No idea. Tie yourself out, scrub. Swing at me. Now you're doomed! Ow! I'm winning. It may take... one more hit and you're doomed. Come on, come at me, bro. Surrender to me. Wow. I love how I'm just waving around like I'm drunk. That's adorable. I do like this game. I keep saying that, but there's a lot going for this game. So it's got multiple mini games. On each island, there's one of each, and you've got to complete each to go to the next island. Obviously increasing in difficulty. Case in point. Haha. Aha. Aha. Using that amazing fast dash, man. I was kind of hoping the dash would actually jump two spaces, but it just jumps to one. Oh. This is gonna suck. I knew it was gonna suck. Right, let's do this. Right, so I've got to jump into that one and then dodge to the next one. Right, ready? Aha! Alright, okay. I'm learning. Alright, as soon as he goes. Dodge. There we go. Boosh. Whoa. I do not approve of that one, but I do approve of this. Aha. Go. Oh, snap. I'll chase you to the ends of the earth. I'm having legit fun here. Oh, boy. Not bad for an E for everyone game. Oh, look around. My treasure. Oh, this game's really good. Oh, can we keep it? Can we keep this game? Can we keep it? Nope. Your pirate rank has increased. I'm now a navigator. Check your map for new islands. Okay. But first, we have to defend ourselves. They want to take it back. Give them no quarter. This is our island. We sail for NASA. Oh, look at me. Proper pirate now. Yarr, shiver me timbers. Captain Dan. Taking over. Bring me a wench. I need someone to talk to and have a hug with. There we go, I think we're winning. 8? Does that mean how many I've killed? How many I have to kill? Right, I think that's how many I have to kill. Yeah, I got 6 left to kill. Come on, bro. Come at me. Don't worry. It's a shame they haven't got like a little animation to show the pirate swimming away. You know, because nobody dies. Nobody dies. But apparently they do. Oh, no, no. These are drone ships. These are drone ships. It's fine. To be fair, though, they are faceless enemies, aren't they? Faceless ships. They could be empty. I mean, you don't see anybody actually on the ships. So I suppose they've got that going for them. That's a good excuse. There's just blown up wooden things. That's fine. You have conquered this island. Well done. Jolly good show. So, yeah, that's... pretty darn cool. How long have we been playing this? About 12 minutes? Huh. Still pretty darn cool. I think the next island's literally just right here, isn't it? Yeah. We'll put a marker on it anyway, because we're professional. Alright, let's jump in. I've not lost, per se, yet.
But I imagine this game more difficult. The second person, it was a bit more difficult. I wonder how much more difficult this third person will be. Oh, he knows his stings. Come on, come closer. I'm ready for you. Come on. Come on. Come on. Keep going near me and I'll just keep hitting you. I'm not bothered. Meh, hey, meh. He's the defender of this island. Only I shall defend this. Oh, not this time. Yes, I am champion. You have lost. Surrender. So you just keep doing special moves. Seems to be the way to win. Success is mine. Yeah, you better beg for your life. Don't worry. I'll let you live. In exchange for you to work on my ship. Time bonus. Life bonus. Sweet. So you can increase your scores. It's pretty darn cool. Alright, I want to see how... these ones I do like. Oh, whoa, they're traps! Oh! Alright, so I take it the one in front of me is a trap. Aha! And that one too, yeah. And this one here, yep. Oh, but there's some treasure over here. Whoop! Aha. Oh! Ah! You can jump over them! Shiver me timbers. Okay. Let's see. Ooh, that looks like a nasty booby trap. Jump over it. There we go. Can I look in a direction? I can look in a direction before I run. That's handy. So you tap it slightly, and it'll just go. None of these seem like collapsing ones. Just gotta keep grabbing all the good mans. I wonder if you can destroy those, things. Can't go over there. This is pretty fun. This is, you know, for a kid, this is fantastic. This is, if you've got a child that loves Pirates of the Caribbean, holy snap, this is probably one of the best gifts you can give to them. You're playing as Captain Jack Sparrow, pretty much. You know, not by name. That was probably one of the agreements, I imagine. But it's a relatively fun game with a bunch of mini-games that get harder and harder with difficulty, and eventually you'll beat the game. There's a limited amount of islands. You can go to each one. You can go back to the easier levels and practice if you really want to. Or increase your score. That's pretty sweet. And it's also got its own save progress, so you can come back and continue it later. No plug-and-play has that. That I know of, anyway. None of these era ones, anyway. This is the first plug-and-play I think I've ever played that actually has save states on. Not save states, but, like, probably some EEPROM to save on or something like that. It's still pretty darn cool. I don't think any ships are going to come from the left. This makes it a little bit easier. Huh. Oh, we've got a health bar at the top. This isn't exactly difficult. This is probably the easiest one yet. But then again, I'm in my 20s, you know? I should find this relatively easy. A child might not find this as easy. So I'm not gonna take the Mickey out of it too much. Let's see. You've conquered this island, well done. Boom, we've conquered yet another island for our Empire of Amazingness. And now, as you can see, I'm doing exceptionally well. So we've unlocked number... So can we actually go to ones we haven't unlocked yet? Let's give it a go. Place a marker. Let's go to one we haven't unlocked yet. I imagine we can... Oh! Press the wrong button. Nice! 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 Come at me, bro. Oh, treasure! Come here! You're mine! Yeah! This is fun. This is literally a poor man's black flag. Alright, so I guess we can't go to this one. We have to unlock them. Okay! Again, cool. Imagine we can't go for these little fishy mans. Fishy, 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 fishy. Nope. Okay, so yeah, pretty darn cool. I do like that. So let's go out for some final thoughts of this little amazing plug and play. Alrighty, so what are my final thoughts on this pretty awesome plug and play? Pirates of the Caribbean. It is awesome, and I even said that looked cool with the LED on, and as you can see, it really does. It takes 4 AA batteries. It is a screw top, so if you're worried about children getting all of the batteries, just screw it in. And they won't be able to get to him, which is pretty darn cool. Don't forget about the batteries, though, because I know I've bought so many of these plug-and-plays With the screw in, it's still screwed in and batteries just left in and they've leaked all over it and pretty much destroyed the console. So always remember to unscrew it and take out the batteries when you're not using it. But other than that, absolutely fantastic. The joystick is actually quite responsive, despite being a small little nub type thing. It's actually really, really fun. I didn't find that uncomfortable to play with at all. It was actually pretty damn fun, and I'm still actually playing the game. Because I left it on just to show the LED. Let's turn that off now. There we go, much better. But yeah, otherwise pretty darn fun, pretty darn enjoyable. The buttons, responsive as hell, pretty darn fun. And it can be stored away pretty nicely like that. It does have the cable sticking out the back of the composite cables, but other than that, it's really not a bad piece of kit. This is probably the best plug and play I've played from JAKKS Pacific so far. They're all very, very fun little games. They're never really boring. They're absolutely really enjoyable, and for a child who loves Pirates of the Caribbean, this is an absolutely fantastic present for them. Even if it is 11 years old, if you can find this on the cheap somewhere on eBay, or in a flea market, or even in a charity shop like I did for a few quid, go pick it up. It's really, really good, really awesome, and, well, I destroyed the collector's value. Edition 1. Destroyed. But anyway, let me know what you guys think of that. It's actually pretty darn fun. It's a shame about it being composite, but again, it's 11 years old. I imagine more modern ones would not be composite. Who knows? Maybe JAKKS Pacific still brings them out. I think I do. I'm going to check that out. See you guys next time. Take care.